Hello everybody, June is here and it's a busy, busy month for video games because E3 is right around the corner, but also a whole buttload of new games are on the way, so let's make this really quick because I got a whole bunch of other stuff I have to do this month. Here are June 2021's biggest game releases. On June 1st, the Warhammer 40K universe gets a little bigger and a little louder with Necromunda Hired Gun, which ditches all that turn-based nonsense for big, loud, first-person shooting on PS4, PS5, Xbox One, Series X, and PC. Then there's Ghosts and Goblins Resurrection, which is on PS4 and Xbox One and PC, following its Switch release from earlier this year. The cooperative espionage puzzle adventure Operation Tango hits PC, both PlayStations, and all 3.5 Xboxes. And then, of course, the Elder Scrolls Online expansion, The Gates of Oblivion, comes to PC and Stadia, and will be hitting consoles later on in the month. On June 2nd, Sludge Life hits Nintendo Switch. This is a Devolver-published indie which is officially described as a first-person, open-world, vandalism-centric stroll through a polluted island full of cranky idiots. Sounds nice. That's already on PC. On June 3rd, get ready to put the pedal to the other pedals with Tour de France 2021 on PS4, PS5, Xbox One, Series X, and PC. And if that sounds like too much cardio and bicycles and spandex, you can swap that bike and the unitard for a desk chair and some nice spreadsheets in Pro Cycling Manager 2021. It's a lot of work keeping these bicycle men in... I'm sorry, I don't know what a Pro Cycling Manager does. Somebody's gotta manage these bicycle guys. Somebody's gotta manage these bicycle guys going up and down hills all day. They're just pedaling every which way, drinking all sorts of sports juices and whatnot. I don't know what that game's about. Anyway, on June 4th, Sniper Ghost Warrior Contracts 2 lets you shoot people in the head on PS4, Xbox One, and PC, and then DC Superhero Girls Teen Power on Switch probably doesn't let you shoot anybody anywhere, but seems like a nice time nonetheless. Also that day, the puzzle-focused Ori-like Evergate comes to PS5 following its release for basically everything else last year. And The Last Kids on Earth and The Staff of Doom comes to PC, PS4, Xbox One, and Switch, adapting a popular young adult graphic novel series turned Netflix show that I'm just now hearing about because I'm old and out of touch. Finally, there's the deep space survival horror game The Persistence, which will persistently scare your space pants off of you on PS5 and Series X. On June 5th, another new Goose game is out, except this one actually has a title, and it's called Mighty Goose. The game is kind of like Metal Slug, except it's about those horrible birds that crap all over soccer fields. That's on basically everything that comes with the controller, except for Google Stadia. On June 8th, chug some mead, launch your friends out of catapults, throw roast chickens at people, and otherwise get medieval in Chivalry 2 on PS4, 5, Xbox One, Series X, and PC, and if you'd rather do more serious stuff involving swords, there's always the Elder Scrolls Online, now for PS5 and Series X, with consoles also getting that Gates of Oblivion update I mentioned earlier. If that's not enough sword stuff for one day, the 8th is also the PC release of Edge of Eternity, a JRPG inspired by Final Fantasy, which is technically an FRPG because it's made by French people. If you'd prefer a JRPG actually made in Japan that isn't inspired by Final Fantasy, because it is a Final Fantasy, Final Fantasy VII Remake Intergrade comes to PS5 on June 10th to hold you over until they finish remaking the rest of that damn game. I want to ride chocobos and go snowboarding already. That day also sees the release of Ninja Gaiden Master Collection on PC, PS4, Xbox One, and Switch, or maybe that day doesn't see the release because ninjas are sneaky and they operate under the cover of night, but either way, that game is coming out then. If you missed out on Hyperdimension Neptunia way back on PS3 and then missed out when they remade it on PS Vita and then remade it again on PS4, well, great news because they finally remade it for PlayStation 5 and now it's called Neptunia Reverse and it's out that day as well. On June 11th, PS5 gets Ratchet and Clank Rift Apart, which must be enunciated lest you sound like you said ripped a fart by accident. That will hopefully give us a better idea of what the PS5 is capable of, but at the very least, it has a gun that turns people into shrubs, which is hilarious. PS5 and PS4 and PC also get Guilty Gear Strive that day as well, so you can make gorgeously animated people wearing way too many belts whip each other's asses faster than the human eye can even comprehend. Meanwhile, Nintendo Switch gets Game Builder Garage, which teaches the basics of game design and lets players share their creations on the internet, and you know that's gonna get real weird in no time at all. Also on Switch, as well as PS4, is Darius Burst EX Plus, another Chronicle, which is great if you don't think any of these other games have enough laser bullets, or flashing lights, or giant space slugs, or titles that sound like the memoir of a prescription drug. On the 22nd, you can squad up and party down with three friends to wail on some D&D monsters in Dark Alliance on PS4, PS5, Xbox One, Series X, and PC. If that sounds too rowdy and you need some damn peace and quietus, there's also Ender Lillies Quietus of the Nights on PC and Switch. It's the quietest game on this list. On the 24th, Alex Kidd pays a visit to Miracle World DX on PS4, 5, Xbox One, Switch, and PC, and PS1 RPG classic Legend of Mana gets a big HD remaster on Switch, PS4, and PC. Also on PC is Roguebook, a deck-building roguelike from the creator of Magic the Gathering. Golf is a nice, quiet, laid-back sport, unless Waluigi shows up and starts making a scene, and that's exactly what's going to happen in Mario Golf Super Rush, hitting the Switch on the 25th. You can beat up some super cool-looking monsters using psychokinesis in the anime-looking brainpunk RPG Scarlet Nexus, which is on all the PlayStations and the Xboxes and the PCs that can run it. And last but not least, roses are red, violets are blue. Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 1 and 2 is out for Switch, and I will not stop quoting that stupid meme when talking about that game. I think it's very funny, and I just won't let it go. Let it go! On the 29th, Nintendo Switch players can destroy all humans, finally, or defy their destinies in Disgaea 6, Defiance of Destiny. Hey, this guy right here defying his destiny, get a load of that! Anyway, there's also Curve Space, which takes classic arcade action but makes it, you know, like, all curvy and in space. That's on PS4, PS5, Xbox One, Series X, Switch, and PC. And finally, PC, Switch, PS4, and Xbox One owners can revisit the classic 16-bit LucasArts games Zombies Ate My Neighbors and Ghoul Patrol and see if they are as brutally hard as you remember them being way back in fourth grade. And I think they are, even with the additional save states for the re-release. Oh, also at some point in June, Phantasy Star Online 2 New Genesis is supposedly fully launching. It is currently in beta, but only in the West on Xbox and PC, but I guess it's on PS4 and Switch in Japan, and I don't know if that's going to change at some point. They should probably send out an email or something. Anyway, as always, we probably forgot something or got something wrong or something got announced or delayed or canceled since we shot this video, but this month we have a good excuse for being behind, and that is we're getting ready for E3, where they're going to announce all kinds of new games, and I'll have to start thinking of clever, funny ways to announce their release dates in a video 5 months from now, and also think of excuses for why we forgot to put stuff into the July video, which we'll make a month from now. As always, thank you all for watching. I very much appreciate it. Actually, no, I'm a little bit mad because enough of you watched these videos that it was a success, and now they make me do one that's for all of the stuff that's coming to the different video streaming platforms. So if you want to find out what's on Netflix or Hulu or Disney Plus or Amazon Prime Video or Shudder or Ghibli or Gumbo or whatever they're called, if you'd like to watch stuff as well as play stuff, go check that out. It's on the IGN channel. Did you know that Paramount Plus is getting 1,000 movies next month? I'm not joking. 1,000. I'm not even going to list them all. I'm going to go take a nap. Thank you. Good night.